Welcome to the Dave Cave. Today, we are talking Chucky, Season 1, Episode 1, Death by Misadventure. Now, I went into this episode literally blind, in that I didn't watch any of the trailers, any of the clips, anything. I did, however, see a little bit of Chucky here and there, because you kind of couldn't avoid him in the whole Twitter sphere, horror sphere of the world. But I went in completely blind, which I am glad I did, because this show wastes no time. Having any kind of preconceived notion of what this was would, I think, have hurt my first outing with this episode. Because this just starts and goes. Because you have Jake buying Chucky, and then it just goes from there. It does not stop. It is always giving you something new to fill this universe with. This was a very good world-building episode. And you knew that they were going to give care, because the episode opens with Jake, he buys Chucky, but then they explain why. They explain why this middle school kid would be buying a doll. It's for an art project he's working on. Super cool idea, but with that super cool idea and the addition of Devon Sawa's drunk version of the twins, you get that destroyed in this episode. Which is totally a great idea, because you bring it in, you take it out, and it doesn't need to be addressed again. Now they can focus on Chucky and Jake and all of their stuff moving forward. I'm sure it'll be mentioned that he has an art background, but that's done. And not only is that done, we now have Jake's dad's done. Now we can move him into this new situation that I love the way they play this situation, because you have Jake and his father. And that situation was shit. It was. It was abusive. It was emotionally traumatizing. It was not good. Does that mean that Jake's dad deserved to die? Meh. But you have this whole idea of Jake is now free from the situation. And now he's saved by what appears to be a better off family. Well, the writing is on the wall that is not the case in any way, shape, or form, because Junior is being traumatized by Lexi. You have Bree's whole who knows what's going on with that. And I'm sure we are going to get much more on Logan, the uncle, and what's going on with him. And real quick, before we go any further, hit the comments below. I want to know one thing that was your favorite thing from this episode. And I also want one prediction for the show to come. And before I get a little bit too ahead of myself, we're going to take a step back. This show does a very good job, like I said, of setting up everything, but introducing the characters and how they're going to interplay. We have all these little moments with Devin, with Lexi, with Junior, with Oliver, that introduces these characters that we can tell are going to be major players in how Chucky and Jake interact with each other. It's going to be interesting to see how that all plays out. I tried not to watch the extra little clip that they put at the end of the episode, because I'm trying to not see anything, because I want to go in as blind as possible, because, like I said, that very much helped. But what I'm really curious to see is how these new characters are going to interact with the old characters that we know are coming. We know Tiffany is coming, or Tiffany Tilly. There has to be an explanation for where the Tiffany doll is. Andy Barkley is somehow out of the hospital. How does that happen? I'm sure Kyle has something to do with it. Nika Chucky is somewhere in the mix. How is that coming into play? And then also, which doll is this? And how many other Chuckies are there? There are questions left open from Call to Chucky all over the damn place. Because we know that this leads from that. When did that happen? How long ago was Cult of Chucky? Is this a month ago? Was this 2 years ago? Where does it fit? And with knowing that this leads off of Cult of Chucky, there's one thing, one glaring thing that bugged me a lot in this episode, and they might lean into it. It might have just been a cameo, but was the introduction slash showing of Dr. Foley. It's obviously not Dr. Foley, because this... was how we saw him last. He's not okay. Dude's not breathing. But they hired the same actor to do that and be in this show, which they've done that before in this series. They did that with Multiple Malcolm. He was in Curse of Chucky, and then again, he was in Cult of Chucky, but as a much bigger role. I think they're doing the inverse of that, and they're just going to have him be part of it. I really hope that they aren't trying to kind of incorporate it and do another twins thing, or maybe have him be a Chucky. I hope that's not the plan, but they've done weirder shit in this franchise. Overall, I am intrigued by the series. There's funny, and as if you've watched any of my Chucky stuff, you know that I like when Chucky's funny, when it's dark funny. And we got that. The talent show, all of how Chucky really handles himself in this, he's a sick, dark, funny character, which is good because I think they're going to get funny moments, but it's good that he's also twisty, that he's not okay, that it's not everybody's going to be laughing at everything he says. It's going to be not cool shit. And before we wrap this up, there is one thing we absolutely need to talk about. Why, oh why, can they never, ever nail the look of Chucky? Why can't they do it? In motion, they have the stoic Chucky down. Looks absolutely perfect. Boom. But then again, you could buy any of the Trick or Treat Studios Chuckies and pull that off. They've perfected stoic Chucky, doll Chucky. Now you have him in motion, and it doesn't hit for me. It looks weird. Now, if you were going to do this, if you were going to try to do something in motion, instead of trying to do everything they can with everything they can do right now with animatronics, why not just lean back on the original? Go for that look in motion. He looked great in the original Chucky. Now, I mean, I don't want to be that guy, but everybody that shit on how Chucky looked in the remake, they don't get to talk if they're going to defend this Chucky. But as of right now, I'm in. I'm in for this series. I want to see how everybody comes in. I want to see how it goes all together. I really want to see Chucky's endgame, because Chucky's endgame could be a lot of different things. Is he looking to expand his Chucky cult army? Is he looking to just run amok? Is he looking to be Chucky, the killer doll, and digging it? Is he going to possess Jake? What is the end game? And also, what do you think the end game is? I have really no idea right now. I'm thinking it's just chaos, but maybe he's still looking to possess some people. Hopefully next week we get a little bit better idea of what the hell is going on over in Hackensack, New Jersey. But for now, that's going to do it for me. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to drop a like, subscribe, share, all the fun YouTube stuff. I hope to see you back next week to talk episode 2, Give Me Something Good to Eat. But until then, take care.